Thank you. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord.
Peace in heaven and glory in the highest.
Let us pray. Assist us mercifully with thy help, O Lord God of our salvation, that we may enter with joy upon the contemplation of those mighty acts whereby thou hast given us life and immortality through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit, sends the gospel.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it, and will send it back here immediately.'" They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, "What are you doing untying the colt?" They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven." Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is right to praise thee, Almighty God, for the acts of love whereby thou hast redeemed us through thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who on this day entered the holy city of Jerusalem in triumph and was acclaimed as King of Kings by them that spread their garments and branches of palm along his way. Bless these branches, and let them be for us signs of his victory, and grant that we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King, and follow him in the way which leadeth to eternal life, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth in glory, world without end. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, as the crowds acclaim Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth in peace.
In the name of Christ, amen.
Lift up your heads, O gates, lift them high, O everlasting doors.
And the King of Glory shall come in.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who of thy tender love towards mankind has sent thy Son as Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, that all mankind should follow the example of his great humility, mercifully grant that we may both follow the example of his patience and also be made partakers of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. And therefore God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Mark. It was 2 days before the Passover and the festival of unleavened bread. The chief priests and the scribes were looking for a way to arrest Jesus by stealth and kill him, for they said,
"Not during the festival, for there may be a riot among the people."
While he was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at the table, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very costly ointment of nard, and she broke open the jar and poured the ointment on his head. But some were there who said to one another in anger,
"Why was the ointment wasted this way? For this ointment would have been sold for more than 300 denarii, and the money given to the poor."
And they scolded her, but Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has performed a good service for me. For you always have the poor with you, and you can show kindness to them whenever you wish, but you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for its burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money. So he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him,
"Where do you want us to go and make preparations for you to eat the Passover?"
So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them,
"Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is my guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, furnished and ready. Make preparations for us there."
So the disciples set out and went to the city and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he came with the 12, and when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said,
"Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me.
They began to be distressed and to say to him one after another, he said to them,
it is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me. For the Son of Man goes, as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born.
While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them, and said,
take, this is my body.
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them,
this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God.
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them,
you will all become deserters, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee.
Peter said to them,
even though all become deserters, I will not.
Jesus said to him,
truly I tell you, this day, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times.
But he said vehemently,
even though I must die with you, I will not deny you.
And all of them said the same. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
sit here while I pray.
He took with him Peter and James and John, and began to be distressed and agitated, and said to them,
I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake.
And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said,
Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want.
He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak.
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them,
are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
Immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. And with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
the one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard.
So when he came, he went up to him at once and said,
Rabbi,
and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them,
have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled.
All of them deserted him and fled. A certain young man was following him, wearing nothing but a linen cloth. They caught hold of him, but he left the linen cloth and ran off naked. They took Jesus to the high priests, and all the chief priests, the elders, and the scribes were assembled. Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest, and he was sitting with the guards, warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for testimony against Jesus to put him to death,
but they found none. For many gave false testimony against him, and their testimony did not agree. Some stood up and gave false testimony against him, saying, but even on this point, their testimony did not agree. Then the high priest stood up before them and asked Jesus,
"Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?"
But he was silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest asked him,
"Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?"
Jesus said,
"I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven."
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said,
"Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard this blasphemy. What is your decision?"
All of them condemned him as deserving death. Some began to spit on him, to blindfold him, and to strike him, saying to him,
"Prophesy."
The guards also took him over and beat him. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. When she saw Peter warming himself, she stared at him and said,
"You also were with Jesus, the man from Nazareth."
But he denied it, saying,
"I do not know or understand what you are talking about."
And he went out into the forecourt. Then the cock crowed, and the servant girl, on seeing him, began again to say to the bystanders,
"This man is one of them."
But again he denied it. Then after a little while, the bystanders again said to Peter, but he began to curse, and he swore an oath,
"I do not know this man you are talking about."
At that moment, the cock crowed for the second time. Then Peter remembered that Jesus had said to him,
"Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me three times."
And he broke down and wept. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
He answered him,
"You say so."
Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again,
"Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you."
But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them,
"Do you want me to release for you the king of the Jews?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again. They shouted back,
"Crucify him."
Pilate asked them,
"Why? What evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole cohort. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him, and they began saluting him. They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, in the same way, the chief priests, along with the scribes, were also mocking him among themselves and saying,
"He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Messiah, the King of Israel, come down from the cross of man, so that we may see him and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also taunted him. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At 3:00, Jesus cried out with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which means,
my God, why have you forsaken me?"
When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, and someone ran, filling a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said,
"Truly this man was God's son."
There were also women looking on from a distance. Among them were Mary Magdalene, and Mary, the mother of James, and the younger, and Salome. These used to follow him and provided for him when he was in Galilee. And there were many other women who came up with him to Jerusalem. When evening had come, and since it was the day of preparation, that is, the day before the Sabbath, Joseph of Arimathea, a respected member of the council, who was also himself waiting expectantly for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate wondered if he were already dead. And summoning the centurion, he asked him whether he had been dead for some time. When he learned from the centurion that he was dead, he granted the body to Joseph. Then Joseph bought a linen cloth, and taking down the body, wrapped it in the linen cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been hewn out of the rock. He then rolled a stone against the door of the tomb. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where the body was laid. Father, we pray for thy holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve thee.
That thy name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of thy word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do thy will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in thy sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise thee for thy saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in thy heavenly kingdom.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
O God, who by the passion of thy blessed Son didst make an instrument of shameful death to be unto us the means of life, grant us so to glory in the cross of Christ, that we may gladly suffer shame and loss for the sake of thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. The Lord be with you.
And with spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is
very meet, right, and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who for our sins was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself, who by his suffering and death became the author of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make, here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. Remember also, O Lord, thy servants and handmaids. Who have gone before us sealed with the seal of faith and who sleep the sleep of peace. To them, O Lord, and to all that rest in Christ, we beseech thee to grant the abode of refreshing, of light, and of peace. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Saviour Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Bow down before the Lord.
Almighty God, we pray thee graciously to behold this thy family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners, and to suffer death upon the cross, who livest and reignest for ever and ever. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.